Madhuchandan, he's actually been a great entrepreneur in terms of organic agriculture, and it's important to look at this entire picture because this is an individual entrepreneur, very different from what one would call state-sponsored agricultural development. So what is the big challenge? And tell us a little bit about what you've done to show how it has helped in transforming agriculture in the area that you've been working on.
Sure, Ajit. First, I would like to talk about how this whole movement started, organic movement. It is, I have to tell my story. Like I was born in Mandya, raised in Bangalore. I studied in Bangalore. My father was a scientist in Agriculture University, Bangalore, JKVK, and he retired as vice chancellor. So after my schooling and PU, I again went back to Mandya to do my engineering. After my engineering, I worked in companies like Wipro, HP, Walt Disney, the many companies I worked for, across 7 countries. And in 2005, I started my own company in California called Verifya Software. And our family was staying in California. And we had a R&D center in Bangalore. I used to come to Bangalore every now and then. Every 3 months, I used to visit Bangalore. So whenever I visited Bangalore, I used to go around in auto rickshaw. I used to talk to the auto rickshaw drivers, like, where are they from? Most of the auto rickshaw driver whom I spoke to, they said, I'm from Mandya. Most of the auto rickshaw drivers. And surprisingly, whenever I went to my friend's house, the maids who were working in my friend's house, most of them said, I'm from Mandya. If you go to an ATM or if you go to an apartment complex, the old guy who is watching your apartment complex is from a old guy from Mandya. And the nannies, what you find in most of the rich people's house, the nannies are from Mandya. So it was kind of bothered me a lot. So I am an engineer. I am supposed to build my society. Instead of building my society, I was building my home and my family, my daughter, my wife. That was what I was doing. So I thought, this is not right. My youths of Mandya, they are migrating to Bangalore. Most of them have lands, but instead of doing farming, they are migrating to Bangalore in search of menial jobs. I wanted to do something. I wanted to bring that youth back to Mandya. So I quit my software. 2014, I came to Mandya. So I took up a hotel room in Mandya, started staying in Mandya. So what I observed is, I was born in a general hospital in Mandya 40 years ago. 40 years ago, Mandya General Hospital had 8 wards. Each ward had 2 beds. 16-bed hospital it was. 4 wards for men, 4 wards for women. The road next to the hospital, I had 1 medical shop. When I came back and when I looked at the hospital, like I was surprised. The 16 bed, see, when Mandya Hospital was 16 bed, at that time the population of Mandya was 5 lakh. Now the current population of Mandya is about 18 lakh. So the 16 bed hospital should have become 64 bed hospital or 70 bed or 100 bed. The 16 bed hospital has become a 750 bed hospital. The pharmacy, the hospital road had 1 pharmacy, now today has 30 pharmacies in 1 single road, 2 infertility centers, many diagnosis centers. On top of it, Mandya city alone has 52 private nursing homes, Mandya city. And to top it, Mandya has 670 primary health centers. So this is one thing what I noticed. Second thing what I noticed is, my grandparents, 4 of them, my parents, my dad's parents and my mom's parents, 4 of them, now known as living. So the average lifespan of my grandparents was about 92 years. My parents' sibling, many of them have passed away. When I calculated their average lifespan, it was 62 years. In my family, one generation, we have lost 30 years, one generation. In spite of all these revolutions, in spite of agricultural revolution, in spite of increasing so much of technology, one generation, we have lost 30 years. The third thing is, people are not finding agriculture as profitable. people are not finding it as profitable. So they think driving Ola cab or driving, delivering pizza is more beneficial than doing agriculture. So people, youth started migrating to Bangalore. The last thing is farmers who had that ego, who did not want to go to Bangalore and work as a waiter or a waitress, those guys who had a lot of ego, they committed suicide. So this, so by seeing all these things, what I felt is, previously, I remember my grandmother in 1980, 81, 82, whenever I used to go for summer vacation, she used to give me 100 rupees, 150 rupees. They were all rich. My grandmother had gold necklace made of out of gold coins. They had vault. Every farmer had vault. So they were all rich. So that's when I thought, like, we have to go back, not front. So that's when we started this organic movement by keeping two things in mind. One is to uplift, to create awareness by letting them know that our ancestors were doing good. So go back to uplift the economical status of our farmers. The second thing is to make Mandya a chemical-free district by 2020.
Just tell us the story in brief about how organic farming, in your experience, helped bring about sustainability of agriculture, which is, he's pointing out, the main purpose of transforming agriculture here.
See, everybody talks about doubling income. Nobody talks about reducing expense. See, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, don't go too back. Just 30, 40 years ago, in any villages, if you take example of Mandya, only our farmers used to buy one or two items from the market. One is salt, the other thing, one was matchbox. Only two things. Everything they produced in-house. They never bought anything from outside. So whatever excess, they used to grow vegetables, fruits, everything, cereals, pulses, everything. It was like a sustainable farming. Whatever surplus they had, they sold. So always money was flowing from village to village to cities. So now it has become other way around. So earlier, 99% of them they produced, 1% they bought. So they were able to balance. Today, 99% they buy from outside, 1% they produce. Educators like us have made mockery of farmers. One simple example I will give you. 85, 80s, our farmers used to brush their teeth with what? Charcoal, salt, neem. We educators, what we did, we went and told, that is dirty, that's a shit. Don't use it. Take Colgate. Today, what Colgate is advertising? Does your toothpaste have salt? Does your toothpaste have charcoal? Does your toothpaste have neem? So what did they do? So they were producing, they were doing sustainable things. We snatched them. We increased their expenses. But unfortunately, nobody is talking about expenses. We are all focused only on income. Reducing expenses is also income generation.